Hey everyone, for the past 30 days, I've been learning origami, so I thought it'd be nice to share some of the things I learned. So here's 5 tips for learning origami. Tip number 1 is start with easy patterns and work your way up. I know you want to make all these cool creations like a corgi or a dragon, but you really have to work your way up, otherwise it gets really frustrating. I'd recommend taking it slow, find something easy to do like a frog, a balloon, or a crane, and then build your skill set as you go. And if these are too hard, no worries, you're just trying to build up from where you are, and I'd say 2D folds are pretty easy, so they're flat folds where it like look like a cat or like a bat. I found those pretty easy. So if you really want to start from scratch, I'd recommend those. And that brings us to tip number 2, and that's to line up your edges. And it may seem straightforward, but it's something you want to pay attention to throughout the process. So not just your initial folds where you're creating these folds and folding, but also later on when you have small folds or you're lining up different edges, you want to keep that consistency throughout the whole process. So as it gets smaller, you still want to line up your edges because each step builds upon each other and it's really important that everything lines up. Which brings us to tip 3, which is to create straight edges. You may have saw earlier that I lined up my edges where I got the corners and maybe the middle. And what you want to do next is to slide out, or sometimes you would slide in to create your folds rather than pressing to create your folds. Because if you slide out, it creates a lot cleaner of a fold. So as an example of what not to do, if I just kind of press, like you'll see there's gaps, and see how one paper stays down, stays flat, and because I tap this one, you know, like some people will just press, it kind of still floats up. So it's not as clean of a fold. And if you want really clean folds and straight folds, you want to definitely use your finger, push out or push in depending on the fold. When it's a big fold, I'll go inside to out, and sometimes on really small folds, I might go outside to in, where I'll make sure my corners line up first. So this corner, line up a corner here, line up a corner, and then I would slide. Tip number 4 is to learn to interpret origami instructions. When I bought this origami paper on Amazon, not sponsored, I just searched up origami paper. You can literally buy anyone. It came with an instruction book that kind of told you how to interpret origami folds. I'll make it a little bit bigger on the screen so you can read this. So even just learning the basics, such as a mountain fold, it'll have a different type of dotted line. And a mountain fold sounds exactly what it sounds like. So you see how this paper is facing this way. A mountain would create a mountain. Like right now, this would be a mountain fold. Right, so it'd be up here. They'll also have other instructions where it'll be like fold in front or fold behind. And that type of stuff can also help you out for interpreting origami. Tip number 5 is if you ever get lost, really break things down step by step. So an example is we have this fold. I forgot what it was called. And it can look a little overwhelming, and it did overwhelm me at first. And you'll see, okay, if it looks like this at the end, when they fold it, you can really slowly break it down and say, okay, where does each point go? So if these two points where we folded, right? So these two will go in here. And then this top point will go to the center. So if this goes to the center and then it goes down, we'd push these down to the center and push these down from the top. And then you would have that fold. So if you really break things down, seeing where a point in the paper is going, you can hopefully find and understand different folds. And then as a bonus tip, the hardest thing for me was finding a natural progression for origami. Sometimes it can be hard to find what to search next or what's at your skill level. I've saw some people recommend to buy a book if you're really into origami, and that will give you a nice progression of learning origami. I never bought a book. I just learned off YouTube videos, so that's why it's a bonus tip. It's not from my experience, but it's what I've heard. It may be resourceful to you. If you haven't seen my Learning Origami for 30 Days series, you can watch it up here, where I progress from basic folds all the way to making cool things like a corgi, or even a dragon, a T-Rex, a reindeer, a penguin, all these different cool things. Also in those videos, I always link to the tutorials that I used. So be sure to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you all next time.